esteemed panelists and esteemed guests. Well, I deal with agriculture, and probably myself and Dr. Singh, we are the only two representing agriculture here. Now, before we talk what agriculture has to offer, when we talk of a skill, why anyone acquires a skill? Whether he upgrades his skills, acquires a new skill, what for? For getting a livelihood? If he is a starter, or to improve his livelihood opportunity if he is in the mid-career? Then what should be the type of the livelihood which one be thinking of? And when I was working in Andamans as a director of one of the ICR institute, this was a major problem, because there the livelihood was always an issue. That's what sort of the livelihood on which we should work upon, so that it is in conformity with the environmental issues as well as their typical geographical problems. So I coined the term decent livelihood. And that decent livelihood, I said, is a level of livelihood compatible to capability and aspiration of the person. And then after, I said, the next level, that what should be that conformity should conform, it depends upon the place to place. For a place from where the migration takes place a lot, from the area from where I come, that he doesn't have to leave his native place, either from one district to another district or one state to another state. Or in ways that, okay, he should be in conformity with his aspirations. Another point which I will like to bring in the livelihood, not only that aspiration and capability, but also its social acceptability. When these Ola cabs and the Uber cabs started running, a few things, fewer jokes, fewer even reality came out. That few boys who were working at the software engineers in Gurgaon, they left their job and opted for a Ola cab driver, because they were earning more as a Ola cab driver than what they were earning as a software engineer, 25,000-30,000 per month, or if you say 3 to 4 lakhs per annum. But the fellow had no social acceptability. So when his family went for him for a marriage proposals, they told, no, he is working as a software engineer because of his qualifications. Nobody mentioned that he is an Ola cab driver, because that has no social acceptability. So our livelihood options had to come up in these three parameters: capability, aspiration, and the social acceptability. In case of agriculture, it has become a real paradox. You ask to any farmer of any region of the country, and he will say, sab labor nahi milta. All technology you talk, if it is labor intensive, sab nahi ho payega, labor nahi milega. But at the same time, you go, it is unemployment, people are migrating in hordes from the rural areas. And even recently, our finance minister told that although agriculture contributes 16% of the GDP, it has got maximum underemployment. Now the challenge is that how to manage skills. Now we have got the jobs available, but therefore that no labor is available. The expectation is that we should have a better skilled jobs, but for that skills are not available, or that sort of jobs are not available. As we all know, agriculture is the largest private enterprise in the country, a single sector contributing 16% of the GDP, but that's also a harsh reality that 49.5% of people derive their livelihood from agriculture. And I always say 49.5% people contributing 16% of the GDP, growing anything between 0 to 4% depending upon the monsoon. And the rest, 50.5% people contributing getting 84% of the GDP and going anything between 7 to 10%. Now, what the disparity is going to be, so we have to tackle that. And for that, it has got huge employment potential. Only thing what I feel, what I did earlier in my term, now I am trying to do, is that the convert technology. We have got huge number of the agriculture technology available, but mainly, अरे भाई farmer के पास बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं को छोटे scale में रखो और do it like this, for which the skills are not available, people are not taker. So we have to convert them in micro business module. Even I have got the MBA in the agribusiness, and I have now started asking them prepare all, convert all the technology in microbusiness module that I did at my Port Blair stint, and this year again I am doing. They're huge. There can be still a skill for the input supply, a skill for mechanization. Now, with the, when small and marginal farmers are constituting around 86% of the total number, the farmer on his own and individual farmer can't mechanize. So there is a huge scope for that. Local level processing. Most of the time, why the farmer is in dire strait? Because his output is being sold for peanuts because he is not processed, not clay. That has got huge potential exist. For like Bihar conditions, Bihar, especially the North Bihar where I am located, has got the highest productivity of the pulse. But there is no pulse processing places. So one of the farmer told me, sir, agar jyada ho jayega, toh bikega hi nahi humara. Because there is no marketing mechanism. So we need skills so that we can process it locally. We need some infrastructure and we need skills for that for which we are working. Then one of the basics is the cattle feed. Feed constitute around 60 to 70% of the total cost of milk or the even all animal products. But all feeds are manufactured. Now you see the process. The this your basic material for the feed is manufactured by the farmers, produced by the farmer. It is transported to and through the full chain to the processing industry somewhere else. From there it is processed and again through the market chain it reaches to farmers. So by the time it reaches to the farmer, the cost becomes almost 2.5 times or 3 times. Can we have developed technology for doing that and develop the skill for that? Now, milk. Milking has been a tradition with our farmers. But again, the new generation is not ready to invest his energy in that. Can we develop skills? Just simple things with this I am talking. Milking machines are available just for 1 to 1.5 lakhs. Can we develop skills and the required infrastructure so that that can create jobs? And job with dignity. Job not that that is not the, for that people are not available, but the job which the people want to do, that sort of jobs are not available. So we have to convert our requirement in agriculture so that the youngsters can come for that. Skill those jobs. Similarly, I just came out with that as individual farmers where there is no consolidation, he's not ready to bore a well. Even while the whole area is floating on the water, he's not able to bore a well because he doesn't have that much financial muscle, he doesn't need because his plot size is just hardly 1.1 hectare that, at that particular place. And I came out with an idea that why we can't, can we have such sort of the system which can again an entrepreneur. So we need in agriculture sector, which I am trying to do, develop skills for these small jobs, skills which can come up. I will not be talking when our colleagues were talking about $1 million and the $1 billion, but collectively that will become $1 billion. And most of all, our sovereignty depends upon our food security. We have to be food secure. I always say that in 65, we won the war, but still we lost on the table because we were not food secure. And in 71 or in 99, we could take our stand because our belly was full. We could withstand all the pressures of the India because we don't have to beg for the food. Thank you.